Hey guys, what's up? Figured that I'd go ahead and just start this YouTube channel just as a way to keep everybody informed as to what's going on. Makes it a little bit easier so I'm not having to constantly give everyone updates all at the same time. But it's also for Billy, just as like a hey, this is what I did today kind of thing. So that's why I'm starting this. So that way hopefully he'll start to feel better and he can come home, but that way he doesn't feel like he's missed out on anything either while he's been gone, and he can see everything that I've been doing, and this just seemed like the easiest way. So that's why I'm gonna go ahead and start it. And feel free to follow along on our little journey. I'm calling it the COVID Chronicles. So hopefully the COVID Chronicles won't last very long, but who knows what God has in store and all the crazy stuff that can happen with life. So welcome to the Reels life. I realized as I'm starting to edit this video too, feel free to comment any questions that you guys have down below as well. That way I can, you know, see them all, I'll read them all in the comments, and then I can reply to them all there as well. So that way hopefully if people are asking similar questions, I can just kind of put updates there and then everyone can see them all at once. So that's the goal for that. And yeah, thanks for following along. Hey guys, so just bear with me as this content is probably going to be really like grainy and stuff like that. I can't find my camera, so I'm going to try and find that by tomorrow so that way I can start using that instead of my phone. But hang in there. So the update for today is the doctor will call around 4 in the afternoon. He only has to call me once if it was a good day, after he's checked on, Billy and how he's doing. If he calls me more than that, then he's not doing super well. So far he's only ever had to call me once, so that's a thumbs up there. So backstory really quickly as to everything that took place really fast. So it was about 3 days ago, I think it was Friday. He started not being able to breathe super well, and I could just tell something was like off. His oxygen stats, I think, were just way off. So I took him to the ER. You can't go in with them, especially because he had tested positive for COVID 10 days ago now. So he had to go in by himself. So I dropped him off. I walked back to the car. When he got in there, they immediately put him on oxygen. His oxygen stats were just way too low. And they decided that they were going to keep him in the hospital. I started having symptoms 7 days ago, so I am not able to visit him just because he's on the COVID floor. I'm not able to see anyone, so I'm stuck at the house while all of this is taking place. So he texted me telling me that he was going to get admitted, so I went back to the house. I talked to the doctor yesterday. He gets to keep the exact same doctor throughout the whole time while he's there, so I get to talk to the same person every time, which helps a lot. Yesterday he was just super tired and not himself in a lot of different aspects, but they had just started him on different antibiotics and stuff like that, different medications. They got his stuff going through an IV. He's taking some oral stuff as well. And I can't honestly remember what they all are right now. He was also diagnosed with double pneumonia. So pneumonia in both lungs. which is why his oxygen sats were so low. So currently he's on 15 milliliters of oxygen. He has to be down to at least 5 milliliters of oxygen before he can get released from the hospital. So the doctor went in today to check on him. His oxygen sats were doing a lot better. He had fallen asleep and the oxygen had like fallen out of his nose, and he was staying at 91% without any oxygen, which is not good, but it's not as bad as he had been, so that was like really good news. So they're gonna actually start cutting him back on his oxygen starting hopefully tomorrow. Then we'll see how long it takes from there. The doctor said that his heart rate was really slow, which it has always been, but he wanted to go ahead and do another EKG and get results back from that, so I should know that by tomorrow, just to make sure that there's nothing going on cardiovascularly. But as far as everything goes right now, everything is looking really good. He started getting his appetite back. Today he was actually seeming like himself other than just being tired. So that is where we are at right now. So please keep praying for us. As you know, he's still not home and we're not sure what's gonna happen and how long that's gonna be. So we really appreciate it, and please feel free to keep following us on this journey as well. So thanks for listening, and I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.
Why are you talking to me like that? How rude.
Ah. Well, you're still not missing out on anything, you know, because I'm still stuck at the house. But I'm watching some of your favorite things. That was a joke. I'm watching a Hallmark movie. So I figured that I'd just go ahead and watch as many as I wanted now before you come home. See? Ignore our crazy, messy house because I'm too tired to clean it. Yay.
The TV remote just fell out. That's funny.
Anyways, I'm thinking about you while I watch Bob's Burgers. I would show you, but my little camera thing isn't working right. This is what I got for dinner. Because your sister's got me. You know, the gift card. So I ordered like the thing of baklava because I was like, ooh, I wonder if it's gonna taste really good or not. Cause I like never find any place that like has baklava. Anyways, besides the point, literally, this is how big it is. Anyways, so I got that, and I'm literally trying to finish editing this video for you. So Odin's just barking in the background, like, this whole time of the video, not actually. Let's see if we can fix this. There we go. Ah, the irony. Anyways, so we got that. And, oh, this napkin. And I'm still sleeping upstairs, by the way. Just because I miss you. Look at this whole thing of hummus. I found some place that does Mediterranean food. And I was like, yes, please. Came with some extra pita bread. And then I got, like, this sandwich that also has pita bread. I technically ordered two, and it looks like I only got one, so I'm a little irritated about that. But you know how I am with DoorDash. I never seem to get it all anyways. So I'm doing that. I think I finished all of my sweet tea. So I may have to get more sweet tea. Yeah, I need more sweet tea. Drink a little bit of that. Eat up all this stuff. Finish editing this video. And then I'm gonna chill the rest of the night. I love you. Continue watching, because there are a couple things at the end of this that are a couple surprises for you. So stay tuned to till the very end. I love you, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Hi, Billy. Love you, and I'm thinking about you. I hope you feel better quickly, and can't wait to see you when you get out of the hospital. Miss you, and am constantly thinking about you. Love you lots, bro.
Hey, Real, I heard you got COVID. I'm so sorry you're not feeling too good. I pray that you're hopefully out of the hospital already. And just want to let you know, man, that I'm thinking about you. I hope you're feeling better soon. And I'm excited to get back to work with you, ready to joke around with you and disappoint you at least once during shift again, man. If you need anything during this time, just let me know. Praying for your brother.
Billy, get well soon. Get lots of rest. Because you're probably like on 120 hours straight right now. So get lots of rest and sleep. Drink lots of liquid and juice. Probably shouldn't drink coffee, especially concentrated coffee. Trust me, it's not a good option. But get well soon. You got this, bro.